Hey, this is Zach from Black Tide, and you're getting your fix on Metal Injection.
Rob here with Zach from Black Tide. Now, Zach, we go way back.
We do.
We actually are responsible for your first interview, and in my opinion, the best Black Tide interview ever. We have a lot to live up to here.
Of course.
And a few things. First of all, like we mentioned just a few seconds before the interview, your fans hate me.
Yeah.
Because of that previous interview. And I just want to say, you know, like, I don't dislike you guys. I didn't mean any malicious intent. I was just, you know, a little drunk.
Yeah, it happens.
Yeah, you know,
drunkenness happens.
Yeah. But funny story, on YouTube, there was a comment that someone actually spoke to you, and you said that when you would see me, you would punch me in the face.
Yeah.
Now I was like, really? I thought we were bros.
We're kind of like bros.
It's like, what's with the violence?
You know, it was after finally seeing the interview and seeing how it went down, I was like,
But we're cool now, right?
Like, we're great
we're
now.
We're all right. That's right.
As long as this is nothing like the last time.
Well, no, it's just me and you now. It's a little more intimate, you know.
It's
got
true.
Rid of
it's
very these other guys. They were just holding us back.
That's what was wrong. We were being held back.
Yeah. Do you feel like that about your band? Like they're just holding you back?
Not at all in any way, shape, or form.
You like how I segued?
I do like how you did that. That was perfect.
No, but I mean, like, okay, it's been like a year. You guys at Ozfest last year, and I mean, you guys are, you know, people know you. You know,
yeah.
Put it simply.
Well, I mean, compared to Ozfest, we got on there, and we were that band that, you know, was on the main stage. Everyone's like, who are they? Are they some local act? You want a contest or something?
Right.
But no. Little did they know.
Yeah. You were signed.
We had a record deal and everything.
Yeah. So, it's been a year. How do you feel? Are you still into this whole music thing?
Kidding me?
Are you like jaded now?
I've never been more into it in my entire life. I'm a little jaded about meeting famous people.
Okay.
Because back then, you know, it was like I saw like, you know, Blasco or something walk by and I was like, oh. Now I'm like, hey, what's up?
Yeah.
How you doing?
They're just normal people, you know.
Who have superpowers.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I remember the first time you met me, like it was like I had to calm you down. I was like, dude, I'm not even like a celeb. I'm just like Rob from Metal Injection. But I mean, like this time when we met, it was like way better.
Sure.
No comment. All right.
No comments.
Well, move it. So, like, you got what would you say is like? What were some highlights of this last year? Like, what are some things that you did that you were like, wait, am I really doing this?
Pretty much every single tour we were on.
You guys have been on some sick tours.
Avenged Sevenfold, All That Remains, small headlining tour even.
How was that? How was headlining? Did kids show up?
Yeah, actually, kids showed up.
No, I'm just
to a.
Yeah,
it's okay. It's okay. We questioned it too the first two shows. We were like, are kids going to show up? And then they showed up and we were like, yeah.
People like you.
No, when the record came out, it was like more kids showed up. And it was like, yeah.
This tour, who do you enjoy seeing?
On a daily basis, I enjoy seeing Mastodon.
They're fucking awesome. They ruled tonight.
Yeah. I missed it today, actually.
Oh, you missed it? Where were you?
Doing some interview, probably.
Don't you just hate those?
Yeah.
I've been asking a few people this. What would you say is the most annoying question that people ask you, other than the one I just asked you?
There's two that kind of tie for it.
Okay.
First one is probably like, you know, with you guys being so young, what's that like touring? That one's terrible. And the one where they look us dead in the face and they go, so are you guys drunk?
I think.
Sorry.
So anyway.
Too easy.
So you guys are pretty young. What's that like?
God damn, I knew you were going to do that. It's terrible. It's awful. I hate my youth.
Yeah.
I can't wait to be 90.
It must suck being young and, like, not get tired from being at, like, a festival all day, having to sit down and stuff, right? That must be lame.
What, being tired or not being
tired?
Not
being tired.
I'm tired every day.
Oh, yeah?
I sleep like a baby, too.
When do you go to bed, usually?
When the party's done.
9, 10 o'clock?
About that.
Let me ask you a question. Your bassist, did he get another shirt?
Guitarist?
Your guitarist? Is the guitarist with the bad
brain
shirt?
Bassist, too.
You're the bassist?
Yeah.
These are my favorite band.
Yeah.
Dude, I could have swore you were the
guitarist. He did have another shirt for a while. He still wears that shirt. But he's actually no longer our guitarist.
Whoa. What?
Yep.
Is this breaking news?
Not really. It happened about a month and a half ago.
It's not on your Wikipedia.
Maybe 2 months.
It's not on your Wikipedia.
It was on Wikipedia. Then somebody changed it. Ours is the biggest load of crap.
Yeah?
If you read it, there's so much, like... All right, it says that we did Ozfest and all this stuff, and then went and recorded our album in, like, December of that year, which would have been impossible because we were out on tour with Avenged Sevenfold that year, and our single was already on the radio.
Yeah, that made no sense to me, actually.
Not at all.
I didn't believe that part.
Yeah, and there's some other untruths.
Whoa.
On there.
Whoa.
You like how I did that?
That's good. That's good. You're learning the media lingo. You're learning how to work the media.
Yeah, like camera, microphone, boom.
Nice. We don't have a boom.
I know. You guys should get a boom, though.
We're thinking about it, but it's like we need another crew member, and, you know,
right. Or maybe,
it's too much.
Maybe a tripod, and then that dude could be holding the boom.
Dude, you know, we need a producer.
Instead, we got the human tripod right here.
Seems to be really good at this.
That was a gay joke. Kind of. Not really. That was more like a big dong joke.
You like the big dongs?
No, not at all.
Are you sure?
Only my own.
Oh, breaking news.
It's not that big.
No? No. Oh, even more breaking news. That's totally going to be on the Wikipedia, though. Like, the fact that your guitarist isn't in the band anymore, that's going to be stricken. But the fact that
I hope you're the one that updates it.
I'm actually, as soon as this interview's over, I'm going to go on my phone.
And you're going to be making their bass players 2-inch dong.
Yeah. So when did you go from being the guitarist to the bass player? When did that switch happen?
What are you talking? I was never the guitarist. Jesus.
Just trying to cover my own ass.
It happened about 30 seconds ago.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Breaking news. Lots of breaking news.
Very breaking news.
So you guys are opening for Bullet for My Valentine after this?
Yeah.
Are you guys fans of those guys?
Oh, yeah. We did a few dates with them when we were in Europe on this last little trek. We were doing festivals and all that good stuff. And we did, like, probably like 6 shows with them.
Oh, yeah.
And it was amazing.
Did you do, like, those big million-person festivals?
Yeah. Download Festival.
I've heard of that one.
Yeah. Open the main stage.
Wow. What was that like? Was that a little surreal?
I was shaking for the first 2 songs.
Oh.
Because I was that nervous. I'd never seen that many people in front of me. And when I did my whole clap your hands thing, and they all did it, then I was, like, shat myself.
But you, with that power, you should have, like, kind of taken advantage of it. Like, now touch your nose. Now put your left foot in. You should have gotten...
And do the hokey pokey.
Yeah, 100,000 people doing the fucking hokey pokey. That would be legendary.
Actually, my next goal is, like, get everybody to put their hands up. Like, put your hands up. Who's gay?
Oh.
But to, like, 30,000 people.
Oh, yeah.
People.
And then they would totally question their sexuality after
or
that.
Or they'd throw shit at me.
That's the price you pay for being a rock star, right?
What rock star?
Have you guys gotten... You're wearing shades indoors. What are you talking
about? They're prescription.
Oh, okay.
I wear glasses normally. Would you like me to take them off?
I'd like to take a look at your eyes. Whoa. I don't know if I can continue this interview.
See, last interview. I was wearing glasses.
I'm speechless now. We should just wrap this up right now because I can't keep going.
I think that might have been it. You fell in love.
Guys, I got to go. Check out Black Tide. Pick up their record. It's a good one.